Welcome to On Capitol Hill with Congressman Lloyd Smucker, a weekly legislative update to keep you informed on the latest issues. Congressman Smucker, can you give us your perspective on the withdrawal of U.S. troops from northern Syria, as this week a U.S. delegation went to Turkey to push for a ceasefire in the region?
Sure. We did have a vote on the floor this week. I voted opposing the decision to end U.S. efforts to prevent Turkish military operations. I voted against pulling our troops from the region. I think it is very important to stick with our allies when they need us, if they have helped us when we needed them. And the Kurds in this region have helped us, really have been the fighting force. We had about 1,000 special troops in the area training them, but they've been the fighting force to defeat the ISIS caliphate in the area. And so I felt it was important that we help to protect them. There are also about 10 to 12,000 ISIS prisoners in the area that we want to be sure stay in prison, don't have the opportunity to break free and start to regroup. That would certainly be detrimental to the United States. So I voted to, I felt it was a mistake to pull our troops from the region, but I was very pleased with the development yesterday. The president obviously sent Vice President Pence, Secretary of State Pompeo. They led a delegation to Turkey on behalf of the president and successfully negotiated a ceasefire for 5 days to give Kurdish forces in the area time to evacuate an area. And the ceasefire really is a major accomplishment for the administration. It puts an end to the violence for at least a period of time. And, you know, we are ready with sanctions if Turkey does not stop the operation there. So I'm very pleased with the latest development. We'll see how things continue to develop in the area, but I'm really proud of the president's leadership in negotiating the ceasefire.
You joined House GOP leader Kevin McCarthy in support for censure of Congressman Adam Schiff. Can you tell us about this censure resolution?
Yes. So this, again, was a resolution to censure Chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, Adam Schiff. And the reason for that, and there's several reasons, but the background is that Adam Schiff, by the way, as head of the Intelligence Committee, has been sort of the point person running the so-called impeachment inquiry into the president. And during that process, really has misled the American people. So, for instance, for 2 years during the Mueller investigation, he specifically said he had specific evidence that would show there was collusion with the president. He was touting that across the country for a two-year period, and it turned out that was absolutely untrue. And then more recently, there have been multiple times when he has lied about the process. But it's even more important than that. The impeachment process under his leadership has been really done in secret. The American people have not been able to see testimony from individuals such as Special Envoy Kurt Volker. In fact, I can't even see that testimony. I'm a member of Congress, but I'm not able to see that testimony because it's done through the Intelligence Committee. We think it's a terrible way to run the House. We think the House, as a result of the way this of impeachment inquiry itself, has lost its ability to function properly. It's the credibility of the House needs to be restored. And that's led by, as I said, Adam Schiff. So what this resolution is really about is protecting the integrity of our proceedings. That's what this censure is designed to do, to restore a process that is fair, objective, and fact-based, and to reassure the American people that the current debate will not overwhelm our government. It really is a critical moment in the life of Congress and the history of our country, and it's a shame that it's come to this, but it certainly has. So we stand for truth. We stand for the committee running this process in an open and fair process. We stand for bringing integrity back to the floor and to the body of the House of Representatives.
Thank you, Congressman Smucker. We look forward to hearing from you next time.
Thank you.
Tune in again next time for On Capitol Hill with Congressman Lloyd Smucker.